going to lay it out, you know, with the UFOs and their lasers.
Well, I would say that I disagree with that. And the reason why is, what about Jeremiah, the 16th chapter? What about Revelation, the 6th chapter? What are these kings, right, these rulers that go into these bunkers underground, so that they hit themselves in the underground bunkers? So yeah, my question would be, if the whole place is going to be destroyed, what's going to happen to those people? We know they're going into slavery. Or have you not done your research on that slavery thing, man? We might need to get into that.
Yeah, that's
fine. We touched on it last time, man. But let me even ask you that. What are your thoughts on that slavery? Are we going off that teaching? Or is there something?
No, I just think you guys don't – I don't think it's – I don't know how to say this politely. The people who are in leadership in the kingdom, I don't think you guys have a good understanding of who that will be. I think you're falsely putting yourself in that group.
Okay. Is there going to be slavery in the kingdom of heaven?
There's going to be hierarchies. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So you can get
it. So let's say, for example, let's say, like today, we have work, right? You have the boss, and then you have the workers under them. So are we saying that that's going to be in the kingdom?
Yeah. They'll be under the same laws. The same laws of slavery that were in the Old Testament? They will happen.
Right. Okay. So let's say, for example, are we going to, let's say, if our servants mess up, are we going to, like, you know, beat them? Is that going to be in it?
I don't think people will not, quote, mess up.
Okay. I want to ask you one question real quick.
Yeah.
Let me just pull up the scripture real quick. Just bear with me.
Yeah.
I want to read this real quick. This is in the book of Revelation. Now, we know these things are shortly coming to pass, all right? Some of these things written in Revelation are after all this goes down and speaking of the kingdom, right? But then when you go to Revelation 28 chapter, some of that already happened long ago. Anyway, Revelation chapter 2 and let's start at verse 25. But that which ye have already hold fast till I come, and he that overcomes keeps my word, unto him will I give power over the nation. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. As the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. And I will give him the bright and morning star. Now wait a second. It clearly speaks about he that overcomes is going to gain power over the nations.
Yeah.
But then it says he's going to beat them with a rod of iron. So how can we really answer that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a good topic. You agree that Israelites were involved in crucifying Yahushua, right? You understand that?
Yeah, yes, I agree.
Do you believe in the kingdom that he is going to be exercising the punishment towards them as well?
No, because all Israelites are going to receive salvation. The punishment in the kingdom is towards the heathen. The scriptures speak about two resurrections. Say, blessed and holy is he that has part of the first resurrection. But then there's a second resurrection where the Israelites who were wicked, they're going to come back in reincarnation.
So those Israelites that did that and destroyed purity, crucified purity, you believe are going to be forgiven based on what?
Well, again, the scriptures say for all the sins of Israel are forgiven. All Israel shall be saved. I believe all of the sins are forgiven. I want to say Romans, the 11th chapter, but that could be wrong.
So what benefit is it for people who did or did not take part in that? What's the consequence for those Israelites?
Well, okay, it's very simple, because we just said that there's hierarchy. You're going to have some people in the kingdom, let's say, have a mansion. You're going to have other people who have, let's say, sort of like a little apartment built. Okay, not everybody's going to have the same stuff. The scriptures speak of, and bear with me, I'll let you speak in a minute, and then I'll pull up the scriptures for my point. But the scriptures speak about some shall wake to everlasting damnation. Okay, some shall wake to to having that, I took part in crucifying this Son of the Most High. So they're going to always have that fault in the back of their mind. But they're still going to be forgiven and receive salvation. But they're not going to be on that level with the 144,000. So I'll let you respond to that.
I mean, that's fine, I guess. That's not the way I would think about it. But, I mean, that's fine if you think that. To me, that's insane. I think that act of doing that, those are actually the most evil souls ever, you know. It's not non-religious atheists, the Pontius Pilates of the world, that are evil. It's the Tahars, it's those people that God hates the most, because they actually know some amount of truth, you know. And those religious people, those Pharisees, are the ones who are going to be condemned the most and in this lake of fire, you know, which I believe.
I have a scripture real quick I want to get. I'm going to get another one, but I just want to get quick. Daniel 12:2, and many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall wake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. So go ahead and continue what you were saying.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, I'm not trying to shelf this, but I think that, I don't think we'll actually disagree that much, and I honestly need to think about things about the kingdom maybe a bit more, get into those verses about what it will be like. I would say the only caution that I have, especially when I hear stuff from GMS, is that the 144,000 are a group that you guys don't understand. You don't.
You know, okay.
I say that confidently.
Let's ask this question. Do you believe that all Israel is going to receive salvation?
No.
Okay. Now we heard you say that, all right? Now, for those watching on my video and on his stream, he said that not all Israel is going to be saved. I have the scripture right here, Romans chapter 11, and let's start at verse 26. And so all Israel shall be saved. As it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob. For this is my covenant unto them, when I shall take away their sin. As concerning the gospel, they are enemies for your sake, but as touching the election, they are beloved for the Father's sake. For the gift and calling of God are without repentance. For as ye in times past have not believed Yahweh, ye have now obtained mercy through their unbelief. Even so have these also now not believed, and that through your mercy they also may obtain mercy. For Yahweh have concluded them in all unbelief, that he might have mercy upon all. So how would you respond to that? Let me read that first part again. You said that all Israel is not going to be saved. But it literally says here in Romans chapter 11, verse 26, and so all Israel shall be saved as it is written. So how would you respond?
Yeah, you don't understand what an Israelite is. That's my point with this whole thing.
What is an Israelite?
Well, you would agree. Well, I don't know. I'm going to say you would agree. What is your thoughts on like people like Ben Carson, Jay-Z, Puff Daddy, all these people who are going to be used to implement and force the mark of the beast? If they take the mark of the beast and are destroyed in the lake of fire, do you believe that their soul will carry on and enter into the kingdom, or do you believe they're destroyed forever?
Well, the way we look at this is we know that those who do not receive salvation on the first resurrection, right, which only the 144,000 and a remnant are going to be saved from that second death.
Right.
However, we both agree there is reincarnation, so these wicked ones are going to be destroyed here, but then they're going to be brought back in righteousness. I can respect that, but again, brother, how can you get around that? I literally read all Israel shall be saved. Yeah, I don't understand how we can get around
that. That's a point. You don't understand what Israel is. It's a group of souls. You think that Israelite is every Israelite born of flesh here on earth. That's an earthly understanding.
Okay, so you're saying that not everybody that comes from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? Not all of those are Israelites, but only a group of people who believe.
Dude, we see that. That's my whole point. We see that in the world right now. Do you think God looks on Jay-Z and be like, oh man, there's an Israelite. Can't wait for him and Beyonce to come into the kingdom. They're actors, man. I don't know why you guys don't get this. Is why it's not you, but the other people. You guys are reading the news and the clippings and like, oh, the Putin did this and all that. Those people are actors. I don't know how you guys don't get this. All those people in the past, let me finish this point. All those people in the past, that there is a group of souls, there's Israelites around them that are actors, and then there's actors all around them, Canaanites, Hittites, Jebusites, all these nations, they're just actors. And how do you not